Welcome back to MashTips. Today we are going to introduce some interesting feature with iOS 15, FaceTime for Android users. As you know, Apple expanded that FaceTime feature for all users, regardless of platform. Even if you are an Android user or Windows, or even if you are using Amazon FireTab, you can join with the FaceTime calls right from your browser with a FaceTime link. Let us see how to share the FaceTime call with Android and Windows users and check more features available for Android and Windows users here. As usual, it's pretty easy to start a FaceTime video call from any iOS device. You just go to FaceTime, open your FaceTime app, and you can start a new FaceTime right from here. With iOS 15, you can create a link for FaceTime video and share with all participants that you want to join the call. So when you invite any other members on FaceTime, you can easily recognize them whether they are in iOS platform or Android platform. For example, Abdu has two different numbers. So if I tap on here, you can see invite with a message. You have to send in a message to invite him for FaceTime calls. Instead of that, if I'm using his second number that's associated with an Apple ID, then you can see it's turned into blue. Then you can directly request him to add into your FaceTime call. When somebody invites you for a FaceTime call, you will get an immediate pop-up just like you had it before on other iOS devices. Here you can add any other participant with this copy link on here. Even you can use this AirDrop and you can drop to your Apple devices if you have any devices nearby. If it is in a different platform like Android or Windows, you can use any messaging platform to share the link. Let me share the link through WhatsApp for an Android user. So here the Android user can directly join with a link. It's immediately pop up on Android browser and waiting for join prompt. Let me join there. Whoever hosting this video call, they can decide whether they want to allow the new user into the call. You're good to go. You can see that nice tiled window on the screen. Whoever hosting the show, they have full control to add or remove a person out from there. And we have an Amazon Fire tablet here, and let us see whether I can join FaceTime call with this tablet. For Amazon Fire tablet, the native browser is a Silk browser. Paste the link. There you go. So now it's loading the FaceTime call over there, and tap on the join button there. And here you go. Now the FireTab is joined the same call. One additional window is popping up here. So surprisingly, it supports the Silk browser from FireTab, and I can see the video pretty clear on these two platforms. So now the FaceTime video call is running on iPhone, Android Pixel 4, and Amazon FireTab right from here. And especially I use native Silk browser on FireTab to join with this call, and it's working fine. And let me try one more device here. Meanwhile, if you're enjoying this video, please click on the subscribe button below and press the bell icon for more updates. Now I can join with a new platform, Windows, and here is a Windows platform now. That's a Windows laptop joined through Google Chrome. I do have a couple of options for grid layout, share link, camera, and system module. And for the Windows user, they can see whoever are the participants now. There's a FireTab, an Android, and there is an iOS platform. All these three platforms over there. The FaceTime link will work only with Google Chrome and Safari, and it didn't support on Internet Explorer at this moment, but so far it's okay. It's opened in Google Chrome platform and I can join with the Windows system. Now I have all four platforms that successfully connected with the FaceTime video call. Windows OS with the Chrome browser, Amazon FireTab with the Silk browser, iPhone 11 with iOS 15, and finally Android 11 on Pixel 4. All these devices supports FaceTime call at this point. So while you are working on an Android platform, even though it's a browser-based window, you will get almost all the features that you can get on iOS devices. For Android users, they can mute mic or turn off the video camera or switch the camera between the front and rear cam. At any time, if you don't want to continue on the video call, you can leave by tap on this button here. You can tap on the menu button here on Android device and see whoever the participants over there. And you can request the same grid layout right from here. Even if you have an additional participants you want to join, you can tap on this share link. Even though Android users, they can share the link and add more participants into the call, or there is an option to select your camera. You can switch between this front facing or rear camera. And also you have the option to select the microphone. If you are using a headset or something like that, you can choose that headset instead of a system audio. Those are the features available for an Android user, especially they are joining with this FaceTime call through their web browser. For iOS users, they can share their screen right from here through this FaceTime call. There are a couple of other features offered exclusively for iOS users. I have seen the same feature on Google Duo for Android user, but for this FaceTime platform, I just want to mention a couple of features available for this iPhone user. If you want to see your camera, you can tap on the tiny icon here to expand it. Now you can see my background in clear. So you can blur this background while you are running FaceTime audio call, Skype, WhatsApp, or anything. So what you have to do, just swipe down on the control center and tap on video effects and tap on this portrait. You can go back and check your screen. And now you see the background is blurred. And still my edges here, those are pretty clear. I didn't have any problem for viewing my face or even my clothes or the border. It's almost perfect, and at the same moment my background got blurred. So that's an additional nice add-on with this FaceTime video call. And there is an additional feature that you can recommend here, mic mode, where you can select a standard mic or voice isolation to isolate the background noise, or you can go for the wide spectrum. So those are the two additional features that you can enable on this FaceTime video calls. In addition to that, you can add camera effects on the FaceTime call. You can use any Memoji that you want. And I can mask my face temporarily, and you can see all other platforms, my Memoji face over there. And I do have some color filters where I can change the filter on the camera, and I can add some text, or I can do some question marks over there. That's a nice way to convey if you have any questions, and I can see the same question mark on the Pixel phone here. You can do have a lot of fancy things here, and they do have some other additional camera effects that you can add on top of here. If you want to see more iOS features, please check the link here for latest iOS features. Thank you for watching this video, and please don't forget to subscribe our channel. We'll see you in another video.